Hello! Welcome. Brother Andrew, Adam from Adam's Fresh Goodies, and Rob from the Op Scene. Got the Rogue Double Chocolate, purchased it yesterday?
Yeah.
From Beer House in Osset, a local bottle shop here in West Yorkshire.
The head on your beer looks really nice, and there, Rob, it's really dark and...
Dank.
Yeah.
Smells like an Easter egg.
Personally, I get a load of aroma that you get from oats. It kind of brings something slightly metallic about kind of oats, and that's definitely coming through in that.
Almost like extract chocolate, you know?
Cookie chocolate. Yeah.
It almost smells like chocolate cookies, that sort of thing. Mm. Yeah, you're right. I'm getting there is a touch of coffee in there, but it's real sort of like, you know. So, yeah, it's real sort of.
I mean, what I love about the Rogue bottles, it tells you what you compare in pictures from. That's pretty. So it's, even if you can't read, you can basically look at pictures. Cow means meat, pie means dessert, so.
I thought pie meant pie.
There you go.
Yeah, bloody pie, we ate lads.
This one's actually brewed with chocolates, rolled oats, roasted barley, honey, and free-range coastal water, so it should be pretty damn nice.
It also says Pacman yeast. I mean, the Pacman, it's basically that little cartoon video game.
Well, there you go. Yeah,
I mean, like, what happened to Pacman? He's now in yeast form.
There you go.
Anyway,
cheers. Wow, that's thick.
That's
lovely and thick. Mm. There is a slight metallicness to that, but those oats are really giving it that full body, aren't they?
There's a lot going on with that, actually. There's a little slight burn there, almost.
Absolutely.
Like,
touch, yeah. I was going to say that.
Like burnt bread. Chocolate, what I'm getting there. It's more like if you think of like American chocolate, like Hershey's chocolate, that kind of waxy, slightly vegetal chocolate. It's not kind of luxurious Belgian chocolate.
You know, it's like metallic in the aftertaste.
There's a metallic thing going on. There's definitely a big malt bitterness to it.
Yeah, definitely. I'm getting a bit of a woody note as well. Like almost a burnt woody note.
I like these tastes on the back side. It's got nice tasting.
There's not coffee in it though, is it?
I don't think so. It's normally it's that coffee residue colour.
Right on the front of the tongue, you get the bitterness instantly, don't you? You get that bitterness from like extra like sort of dark chocolate and roast espresso on the front of the tongue.
Molasses, big time for me.
Definitely. It's definitely got that sugary tint to it, but it's not as sweet as I expected it to be with a double chocolate stout.
No.
It's actually got quite a fair amount of bitterness to it.
I mean, a brewery very close to where we are now, the Saltair Brewery, the Triple Chocoholic. On tap, that's a really good beer.
Yep.
But on bottle, it gives that metallic feel and thin body. But it's similar to this. I mean, is this bottle conditioned or is it pasteurised?
It's probably not bottle conditioned, is it?
Nah, I think it's probably like a filtered or something. It'll be filtered. As a lot of beer in America is filtered. And
is that the distribution of it and such like that?
People just don't kind of get bottle conditioned beer in America all that much.
Rogue are a fair big brewing company now as well, aren't they, to be fair? With the range that they actually do, right? You know, they tend to bottle condition a lot less the bigger they get. That's the thing that I find, anyway.
Yeah, I mean, they even distill beers to make spirits as well. I mean, you can get a distilled dead guy, which kind of is a bit like a whiskey and stuff.
Right.
But,
I'm getting a creaminess as well, like an actual smell of cream. I know it's not got lactose as part of it, but I'm getting a tiny touch of like creaminess, like lactosey creaminess.
Yeah, it doesn't say what kind of chocolate. It's not saying if it's like chocolate powder or cocoa nibs or what.
Yeah,
I don't know what kind of.
I don't think it's cocoa nibs.
No,
it'd be a bit more intense.
Or chocolate malts.
I mean, you brewed a beer with the Brewdog, and you used the cocoa nibs and stuff.
No, that was 100% Venezuelan cacao. So it's essentially
like
a big rod of
intense
chocolate.
Mm.
It's
getting similarities with that, or is it?
I know what you mean. It's more like kind of a bit bitter chocolate.
Yeah.
Bitter waxy chocolate.
I mean, you used to work through different chocolates to get the best one for the BrewDog beer.
Mm.
Did you work on with these kind of chocolates or
no? Nope. We turned up. James Watt said we're not going to use cocoa nibs because it has too much bitterness. So we're going to use Venezuelan cacao, and I said, well, you're James Watt, so we're doing it.
Not going to argue with that. I tell you what I'm not picking up on, though, the honey.
No.
I'm not picking up any honey, not even in the aroma.
The honey might have been there increase the ABV.
Yeah.
You reckon?
Like Belgians will have candy sugar.
Yeah.
Beers will have honey. I think Pliny, uses a bit of honey.
Okay,
but that's primarily just that additional sugar that isn't kind of malt based, just to kind of.
It's only cheaper to use to alcohol boost sugar.
I'm going to say no, it's hop slam what uses honey. It's like with Belgian beers. If your capacity of your brew house doesn't allow you to brew a beer of a certain ABV, then you've got to add something that gives it more sugar for the yeast to produce that higher alcohol.
Do you all get the 9% of it though?
There is a little bit of a bit. I must admit, it's not hidden massively well, is it? But it's not. I think I get it more in the back of the throat and the tongue rather than the stomach. I'm not really getting much warming in the stomach, you know, like you kind of expect. But I wouldn't say that's sort of off-putting.
It's mellowing out as you drink it.
Yeah.
Whereas before it was like proper artificial beginning, but it's slowly mellowing out to
or like room temperature sort of.
I also like the grown up warning. Which a lot of American beers have. And it says here, don't drink when you're pregnant, don't drink when you're operating machinery. Recently, Stone released a beer because of a recent accident with the forklift truck.
Oh, yeah. Let's not get into that.
But,
tragic accident.
And health problems. You definitely want.
Don't use a steel press when you're drinking that. Use a bandsaw. Yes, it's probably a good idea.
Yeah, it's not a lawnmower beer. Definitely not a lawnmower beer.
No,
it's not.
End of the night.
Yeah, it's more of a sip end of the night. But I mean, I think the only criticism that I've got is a bit like you said, is that metallic taste on the front of the palate.
But that's fading.
It's fading now that it's warmed up a little bit. I think that'll probably, by the time we get towards the end of this glass, it'll probably be gone. But that is quite intense chocolate, and I was expecting some dark fruits, but I can't really get much, to be honest.
I mean, if it was smoked, would you think it'd be much better?
No, because it ruined some of the chocolate flavours. And what they're aiming for is double chocolate.
If you smoke it,
you'll lose that amount of double. Recently, we had the Siren Craft chocolate cake beer.
The Caribbean chocolate
cake. Yeah. And we were hoping that it tastes like a chocolate cake. This tastes like a chocolate cake.
It does taste like a chocolate cake.
It's
spot on.
It's got more.
And then it's more drink it. You're thinking whipped cream.
The thing that I have about beers that say on the front of it, this is a double chocolate stout.
Yeah.
You know, I want it to taste of chocolate. If I'm going to get a beer that says it's an espresso stout, I want it to taste of coffee. And there's nothing more disappointing than when it doesn't. So I'm glad that it does, because Rogue pulled through for me on that.
Yeah.
So definitely.
So you say it's better than the Young's one?
I would suggest that you pour it, let it sit, relax, prepare your dessert, prepare some, then drink it. Because as we initially tried it, it was all metallic.
Let it warm.
But as we've had it now, it's a little bit more appealing on the taste buds.
Definitely, yeah. No, it's nice. I like it.
Yeah. That's the Rogue Double Chocolate Stout. Thanks for watching. You take care.
Goodbye.